guys, if you're new here, I share all kinds of stuff on my channel, homeschooling, homesteading, grocery hauls, gardening, all kinds of fun stuff. Anyways, I wanted to share with you today how we preserve a lot of our yellow squash, because we have so much lettuce right now that we are preserving the squash for later and trying to eat as much lettuce as we can. So anyways, I'm gonna jump right in and show you how we are preserving the yellow squash. I hope that if you have not already subscribed, you'll subscribe and stick around for more. Okay guys, so this morning we picked 4 of these yellow squash and I have washed them, and then I sliced them into about 1/2-inch slices, and I'm going to bring some water in a pot to a boil. I also have a big bowl over here of ice water. So I'm gonna set my timer on my oven for 4 minutes. It only takes 3 minutes for it to actually cook in the hot water, but by the time I get it in the water, it'll be down to 3 minutes. So I'm just gonna scrape this all off this cutting board into the hot water and then just let it go for the 3 minutes. When the timer beeps, I will shut the boiling water off and I will start scooping it all out of there and get it into the ice bath. The reason you use the ice bath after you blanch your vegetables is because the ice bath stops the cooking process. So once they're in that water, they start to cook, and then you throw them in that ice water, and that's what stops the cooking and brings them to a cool point so that you can freeze them safely. And when you take them out later and cook them, they aren't going to be mushy or ruined. All right guys, so my timer has went off on the oven and it's time to start pulling the squash out. I'm just going to go ahead and start pulling out the smaller pieces first, and then I will get the bigger pieces last, just because the smaller pieces don't need quite as much cook time as the larger pieces. And I mean, in reality, I could just scoop it all up and dump it in the water, but I just want to make sure that the smaller pieces get cooled down quicker, and it's not going to hurt the bigger pieces to cook longer. And I'm particular like that, so that's what I am doing. Also, while I'm pulling this squash out of the water, I want to ask you guys a question. I have 3 kids who really just like yellow squash sauteed in butter with some salt and pepper. My other 2 don't seem to like it, and I do not really like yellow squash. So my question is, do you have a recipe that you love for it that you would share with me, that maybe my littles and myself who do not like it might start to like yellow squash more than we do, because we are going to have tons of it. So we are going to eat it whether we like it or not, because like I said, we've probably got 40 out there and we'll have more, and I want to make sure that we're not wasting it. But I mean, I'll eat it, but I don't love it. CJ, Mika, and Penny love it with just the salt, pepper, and butter. Anywho, back to what we're doing. All of the squash is now in the water bath and it's cooled down a few minutes. So now I'm just using my strainer, I'm scooping it out, and I'm gonna put it over here to kind of drip off some of the water. While it drips off the water, I will spray down a pan with some cooking oil. And once the squash has dripped off for a few minutes, I'm gonna lay each of the pieces on the sprayed baking sheet so that it doesn't stick when I put it in the freezer. And then I'm gonna freeze it for like, I don't know, 30-ish minutes, and then I'll bag it up and we'll freeze it. The reason I'm doing that is so that all the pieces of squash aren't stuck together, and it's just easier that way. If I only wanna make half the bag, I can use half the bag. If I wanna make the whole bag, I can make the whole bag. So here is my greased pan, and like I said, I'm just gonna lay the squash all over the pan like this and get it ready to pop in the freezer. Okay guys, so it's been a little over an hour. Here are the squash. As you can tell, they are pretty firm and frozen. So now I'm gonna put them in a bag Some of these I've been putting in vacuum bags, sealing them for long term. Some of them I've been using these resealable bags a friend gave me and sealing them up with my vacuum sealer, but they will not get airtight with my vacuum sealer. But it's okay because these ones I plan to start eating after we're done with all the lettuce in the garden. Okay, so that is it. That is how I preserve our squash for the freezer. I hope you enjoyed this video. It was kind of short, but I thought I would share anyway. I will talk to you guys later. Bye.